Hey friends, my name's Chad, and this is Love Always Adventure Often. On this channel, you can follow my family's adventures, you can get tips and hacks on adventuring with your own family, and every once in a while, I share some of the gear that is in my gear bag. And today, we're talking about the Yeti 400 from Goal Zero. Pretty. Hey friends, we're the Browns. Chad, Katie, Addison, and Kenya, Milo, and Charlie. We live to love an adventure. This is our story of leaving the norm behind to travel the United States full time, spreading love and encouraging others to do the same. Our family motto is Love Always, Adventure Often. So hit subscribe and join us for this incredible journey. Okay, so it seems like more now than ever, we need electricity when we're out boondocking. Now, me specifically, my specific situation is I work a lot while we adventure, so that allows us to take off for longer and do more things, right? So today I'm talking about the Yeti 400 from Goal Zero, which is actually one of their basic storage units in their solar system. And solar is so big right now. There's tons of different solar systems out there, storage systems, all that kind of stuff. We looked at a bunch of them before we decided to go with the Goal Zero. Goal Zero is awesome for a couple of reasons. One, it's very simple to use. Two, it is very durable. This unit, the Yeti 400, plus the panels that we use, which are the Boulder 30s, to charge this when we're out boondocking, is they're durable. We've dropped them, we've bumped them, we've rolled. That stuff just happens when you're out and about, and these things have been tanks for us. So those are the reasons I love the Goal Zero system. I wanted to show you some of the features on the Yeti 400 so that you can better know if it's good for you, and also talk about some of the ways that we use it. So one of the advantages, one of the things I love about the Yeti is actually this display here that shows us the input, the output, and the battery level. So at any given time, you can see how much power is coming in if you're charging, whether it's solar or here at the house, and you can see how much is going out. Whatever you have plugged into this, you're running off of this, it's gonna tell you the exact measurement of watts that is going out of the Goal Zero. That's important so that you can know how long it's going to last and how long you're going to need to charge it for. And then obviously it shows you the battery level here to show you how much power is left in your Yeti. So up here first you have the input. This is where you plug your either your panels in or you plug your wall charger in. It's so important for you to read the instructions when you buy your Yeti, because one of the things that I found out when I read my instructions is that this thing should be plugged in at all times when you're not out and about. The battery should be fully charged and plugged in. In fact, if it goes dead and sits dead for a little while, it'll start this annoying beeping sound, and that is built in to remind you to plug it in, because if this doesn't remain plugged in, it can actually get ruined by sitting empty. Now, let's talk about where you can plug things in and some of those features. So one of the outputs is this 12-volt cigarette lighter. This is awesome. Each output section has its own engage and disengage button. So you can engage the 12 volt here, plug something in, you're charging. You can actually leave it plugged in and disengage it, and it won't be using any of the power at all, which is really cool. You don't have to unplug everything if you don't want to. So we don't use this plug as much, the cigarette lighter, the 12 volt cigarette lighter one. This is the one we use the most common, and this is the USB output. And obviously our phone chargers, our tablet chargers, all are USB. We don't have to have the little plug adapter, which is nice. So there are two USB outputs. You just plug your phone or your tablet or whatever you're charging right into those USB ports. Boom, you're charging. It's awesome. Next, you have an AC output, and there's two of them, which is also cool because, like I said, a lot of times when we're out, I'm working, and I'm working on my laptop. And so this is perfect. I can plug my laptop into here. I can run it for hours and hours off of the Yeti, which is so handy. I don't have to preserve my laptop battery. I don't have to worry about not getting my work done. It's all there, right there, in this little unit. Couple things about this. It is kind of heavy. Not as heavy as others that I've picked up. It does have this nice convenient handle that pops into the unit and out of the unit. That's really cool. The other thing that I love about it is the rubber feet on the bottom. They're super heavy duty rubber feet, and they prevent it from sliding around. So we've actually put this on the shelf in our trailer and drove to our destination, and it did not move because of these feet. So that's been really, really handy. So rarely do we need to recharge the Yeti 400 on a 4 to 5 day trip. And that includes working off my laptop, charging our phones, and charging our tablets. So it holds a lot of power. When we've been out for a while, that's when we have to use the solar panels to recharge. So if you're searching for a solar system for your camper, your trailer, your van, your tent camping, whatever it is, I highly recommend you take a look at the Goal Zero Yeti 400. I will talk about the panels that I use in another video, but they also make incredible panels, and the entire system is very cohesive, very easy to use. So thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, share, all of that kind of stuff. More to come soon, but until we talk next time, love always, adventure often.